Hello friends, today we'll see how to use Laravel on Windows 10 or Windows. And we'll search for Xampp server. So open a browser and type in Xampp server and go to download option and you'll find your suitable version. I'm going to go ahead with PHP 7.3. You may take whichever is good for you, but I'm going to take this one, 7.3. Click on it and it'll download for you. Go to download section and you will find this installation file. We also need to install Composer. So let's open up a tab and search for Composer. Okay, and it'll pop up a new page. Go to download option and click on it. And we need Composer for Windows installer. Okay, so well, there are a lot of options. These are command line options for Linux or Mac, but we are going to click on this one and it'll download it. And we have both installer file in our download folder. So let's go ahead and install Xampp server. Double click on it and you say yes. And next we'll just simply follow the steps. Well, there might be a warning. So it is trying to write files in our computer. And right now it's missing permission. And we need to give it to some permission, which is called UAC. We can do it before the setup or after the setup. For now, we'll just go ahead and click OK button. It'll pop up a new window. And over here we'll just keep clicking next, and over here we're going to select all of them. Okay, so go ahead and click next. We'll install it in C folder. You can change wherever you want. Go ahead and click there and change its location if you need. In general, we do it in C folder. So go ahead and click next. And we'll set English for our language. So we are going to select English. Just go ahead and click next. And I'll fast forward this section, okay? And after this, we are almost going to finish with the Xampp server. And we'll click on Finish button. And it'll start the control panel automatically for Xampp server. So this is the control panel from where you control your servers like Apache, MySQL, FileZilla, Tomcat. There are a lot of different options. So this is from where you will control your MySQL and Apache. Let's go ahead and minimize it now. Now we'll go ahead and install Composer. Double click on it. So click install for all user and go ahead with yes. And over here we will choose developer mode. In general, because we are developers, we should check this mode. If there are errors, it will help us to know. But if it's in production server, you will not choose this one. In your development server, you'll check on this server. But most of the time, actually, Most developers use either Mac server, Linux server, or cloud servers. Go ahead and check developer mode for now, and go ahead and click next. So now it will install the composer in C composer directory. So our Xampp and Composer in the same directory. And this is also our PHP path. So let's go ahead and check our PHP path. Let's open it up. Xampp. Okay, PHP, PHP. Yes, you can see PHP from there. And yeah, the path is same. So add this path to your PHP path. Now here it might ask you for proxy settings, but for most people we don't need this. So it's a dedicated IP or URL. So we'll keep it empty and click next. And now we are going to ready to install whatever the necessary things we need. And if your composer doesn't work, you have to do the following steps. And at last it says that if it acts up, then you can go ahead and restart your computer. Okay, if you want to see the documentation, click on this, but I think we don't need this now. So as of now, we have Xampp server and Composer installed in our system. Next, we have to install Laravel in our htdoc directory. Okay, so let's go ahead. So let's go ahead and check our PHP configuration first, which is very important. Click over here and php.ini file and search for extensions. We have to open up some extensions. Those extensions would be used by Laravel. So you see the extensions, a lot of them are open, but we need more extensions, okay? So let's go ahead and find the CURL file info, which is very important, and mstring is also open SSL. Yes, we need to open SSL extension, and SQLite is also necessary. Let's see what else we need. We also need scroll down. Let's check. Okay, XML, I think we need that. And let's go ahead and save this file. Control S. Now let's go ahead and start our server. Now allow. And allow access. It's basically talks with the firewall to start the server. Start MySQL as well. These are two things we need. And also click on allow access. And we have to, let's go ahead and find our htdoc directory. Find Xampp and htdocs. Well, this directory is your documentary root for localhost. Let's open up a browser and write down localhost, and you'll see that we have a panel. So it has Apache, MariaDB, and PHP and Perl. So now we need to set up our Laravel, and we need a command prompt. Let's go ahead and type cmd. Here we go. And uh, let's go to our htdoc folder. So let's write cd dot dot. It is one step back, and for me it could be different for you. Go ahead and find Xampp over here and then write htdocs. Okay, so this is our document root. So just go ahead and find your htdocs. That's all you need to find, and then you need to find dir. And here we'll use we need to do composer, and so using this composer we can create a Laravel project. And for creating a Laravel project, you need to do composer create project Laravel, and you have to name your app. Okay, you can name whatever you want, but I'm going to name it my app. Okay, and then hit enter. It'll go ahead and create our Laravel project and download the necessary dependencies, files, and a lot of things. So it's loading with its dependencies. So just wait. If your internet speed is low, it might take a bit of time. But for me over here, it's quite fast. And it's pretty much done over here. Okay. So let's go ahead into CD my app. Okay, so we are going into the application folder, and you can do dir, and you'll see all the stuffs and files over here. Okay. So here you can, here you can see that my app, our application folder. So in order to start our app, we need to type in PHP artisan serve. Okay, and this will open up our Laravel application. So this is our server IP, and this is our development server. Copy this and type it into, or paste it in your browser. Okay, and paste over here. Here we go. This is our Laravel application. Great.